Okay, I think I might have this figured out. Not a wee little part, it's actually a tweezer holder. Part for tweezer holder. I use slicer to make the G code. That's showing it's supposed to move to the home switches and then move over to the center and put an outline around the part and then start making a part. I loaded it onto the SD card and I can read off of it so I can SD print. See right there, there's tweezer H. I could load off of that. I'm just gonna run it off of the laptop for right now, but okay, it's getting up to temperature. I don't have the temperature set in prompter face. It's still showing off. I have it in the G-code. It's supposed to get up to 195. And I figured out the W is weight. It's got to get up to 195. Wait for 30 seconds and then it'll start the program. Up to 194. So I'll be back. Okay. It's up to 195 degrees. Now the clock's counting down. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. There we go. This is just a little perimeter that was supposed to put around the part to get the nozzle going. Hey, it's actually doing something on there. Man, that was fast. It's actually printing something where it's supposed to be printing something. Holy shit. Excuse my language. Actually making something that's looking like a part now. So you can see the little stringy thing around the outside of the back. It's supposed to have been all the way around the part. They say to put that in there to give the extruder time to start pumping out fluid. So I'm thinking I'm going to make that thing a bit bigger from now on so that make sure I get enough filament coming out before it starts the actual part. But it's going right now. Look how fast that sucker is going. It's still looking like a part. And I've got these settings on slow. I was following the guy's tutorial on Slicer, and I went with his slowest recommendations for settings. And this is still moving pretty quick. There you go, still looking like a part. Come back later, see? Still going, still looks like a part. Unless I got some little globbies starting in the back. Might be I got a little bit of backlash in this ways gear. Might have to set the retract a little bit higher. It's not pulling back on it, leaving a little globby there in the back, but we'll learn. Okay, this is the part I'm making. I'm making this part right here, right now. I believe. Got that part done. Now it's working on this part here. Thank you. That's right. The guy, I think I'm only going about half the speeds he had on his settings, so could be pretty cool. And this is a PLA, by the way. I don't have my heated bed working yet. I still need a thermistor for that, but I just got the painter's tape on there, and it sticks pretty good to the painter's tape, even cold. Well, I forgot I had this little fan on here. I've seen other people use. I just got it rigged up right now. I noticed it looked like it was getting a little soft there, so I was going to turn the fan on, but apparently it's done already. That's a little fan here. I can just flip it up out of the way or put it down. I gotta let it solidify. It's almost hard now. Gotta remember to. So it's doing all this, putting all this plastic into one spot. I could see where it melted a bit. You remember, put the fan down, turn it on. Okay, program's over. It shut off the temperature. It's slowly working its way down. I can check it down to 125. Here's my part. Hard. There it is. A little bit of, quite a bit of melting there at the top. We gotta remember to turn the fan on. I got a little bit of stringy stuff in there. There we go. It'll go right on there like that. Well, it'll still be usable. You can see it melted and the holes collapsed a little bit. But we'll learn. Clean it up and use it. I'll make another one and turn the fan on this time.